All right, today in the studio I have with me Mike Bannwarth. He is the Director of Catholic Family Sharing Appeal, and Father Scott Traynor, the Vicar of Lay and Clergy Formation for the Diocese of Sioux Falls. Thanks for being here, guys.
You bet.
We're going to talk today. We're going to talk today about the Catholic Family Sharing Appeal, which is coming up next weekend. This will run on the 7th, so it's the next weekend is when it goes out, correct?
Correct.
And you'll see it in your parishes.
Yeah, we'll have a kickoff weekend and then followed by a commitment weekend.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. So, Mike, and most of us know what the Catholic Family Sharing Appeal is, but there might be some new people in the diocese. So can you tell us what this is about and why we do it?
You bet. And many people are aware of it and know what it is. So it's a good reminder as well as for those where it might be new for them. Mm-hmm. So our Catholic Family Sharing Appeal is the annual appeal that really supports all of the diocesan operations and the ministries supported by for Bishop's office. And this is really the one time where all the parishioners throughout the diocese come together and are asked to make an annual contribution or series of payments to support the ministries. When we look at it, the annual appeal covers about 60% of the diocesan operations of the budget. So it is critical to the diocese and in carrying out Bishop's vision and just the operations that we have. It really, if you think of it, supports the ongoing operations here, much as the contributions from parishioners support the parish operations and the ministries that the parish provide on an ongoing basis. And so it is important for us both here and for the ministries at the local parish.
Yeah. So I know a lot of people are probably thinking, well, I don't really care if the diocesan offices get the money. But this appeal, the money that it goes towards to help support the diocesan offices also helps support the parishes, correct?
Correct.
Can you tell me how that does that and what different ministries do that?
Right. And the beauty of it is with the different ministries that are supported here, then in effect, the parish doesn't have to be an island out there on its own. So many of the things that we do are ministries and other things that, whether it's faith formation, religious education, some of those things that we act as a resource here.
Mm-hmm.
And through the offices that we have here within the diocese, they're able to roll out programs and do things and provide that support, not only from a ministry standpoint, but we think of technology and other operations where we're just a resource for them. So collectively as a diocese, then it benefits everybody and not just if you think here centrally.
Right. So this past year, CFSA got a little weird in the middle of the year when things, parishes weren't holding masses and I don't know how to ask this question. Did everything come out okay in the end for the previous year CFSA appeal?
Yeah, you know, actually where I talk about the the overall budget being about 60% covered by Catholic Family Sharing Appeal, parishioners were great, very generous, and much of that, a lot of people stepped up, and obviously for those that couldn't, I think a key of it probably also was so many people support it through their prayer.
Yeah.
So we sometimes think of the monetary support, which we obviously need, but we really need the prayerful support as well. And probably particularly this past year, when you look at the unique circumstances that we were in and everything, it was just really more critical than ever that we had the prayer support as well.
Yeah. So everyone kind of felt a few things this past year that maybe weren't that big of a deal to them in the past. One in particular was the Sunday TV Mass that pretty much everybody had to use for a while when we first couldn't go to Mass. So this is a ministry that has been going on for many years and is meant for those who are homebound, live in nursing homes, are sick, whatever, but the entire diocese got a chance to use it and see that, which was kind of good. Because now you know where that money is going to. That's just one of the many things. So,
and when you think of TV Mass, even and really what we're called to do as parishioners and as a diocese, TV Mass reached well beyond our diocese, as you would know, and really worldwide.
Yep.
And we were able to do that. You know, thinking back at this year, too, there were other more tangible, concrete ways that not only with our TV Mass, but through our technology area, reaching out to parishes, working with them to help them stream their masses at the parish level online and do some things that way, helping with parish websites, reaching out to help with online giving. Reaching
that was a big deal there.
Also very, very big, and reaching parishioners with religious education, faith formation, so many things, tools that they needed online to be reaching out.
And they weren't familiar with how to do that, and also needed a little help with some of the funding, so they were able to get discounts and stuff that was provided from the diocese, which was real helpful.
Exactly. Yeah, you really have that buying power.
Yeah.
If
yeah, you do. So why is it important for us as Catholics to give to CFSA? I mean, we know there's the ministries, but does this do something for us?
You know, it really does. So, we as Catholics in Eastern South Dakota, first and foremost, we're the diocese. It's not just the parish, it's not individuals, but collectively, we all are the diocese. And we're really called to support each other and one another as we have in the appeal, as one family. And, you know, many people have been blessed and just reminded that really everything we have is a gift from God. And so we're really called to respond. And how do we then return those gifts to others that in need, and return those gifts that are really entrusted to us? So, you know, Catholic Family Sharing Appeal is just one of those ways and an opportunity for us to support those that are in need around us. But really, how do we support Bishop in his vision for the diocese? Obviously, we were blessed with Bishop arriving just about
before.
A year ago
now.
So that time certainly has flown by.
Yeah. But
so it's not only those tangible things of where we've come from and what we have, but how do we have those dollars to support the vision for the future and where we're looking at and really where we're going.
Yeah.
And as I mentioned, we focus on the money, but still, you know, now than more than ever, it's still critical that we have the support of our prayers too.
Absolutely. That was a good segue into talking to Father Traynor about the bishop's vision, which is he received from in prayer. I watched your Ignition episode with Dr. Bergwald.
Oh, great.
And I was like, hey, you know what? That was God's vision. So his vision of lifelong Catholic missionary discipleship through God's love. And so, Father Traynor, can you explain to us, how does this vision play into what we do with Catholic Family Sharing Appeal?
Well, you know that Jesus, as he ascended into heaven, gave the great commission to the church to go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to observe all that he commanded us. And as Bishop has set before us this vision that he received from God as a way to direct the diocese of building a culture of lifelong Catholic missionary discipleship through God's love. That is our local saying yes to the Great Commission, which has been given to the church from Jesus from the beginning. And that's a response that we need to make as a diocese. You know, in the Catholic Church, the diocese is the local church.
Right.
So everything that the church has to offer in the world is meant to be present in our diocese. And each of our parishes have different histories and personalities and particular gifts that come together as a diocesan family to make the mission of the church possible. So as we are laboring in the diocesan offices, our whole orientation is always to support the work of parishes. So Bishop has such a beautiful trust in the work of the Holy Spirit that God is raising up in individual parishes the inspirations, the ideas, the resources that they need to respond to that vision in their local area, as opposed to just having like, here's a diocesan program, everyone do that thing, right?
And a top-down thing. It's more of a bottom, a grassroots kind of feel.
Right, it's really being a good steward of the gifts that God is raising up in parishes. Like people are like, oh, this is something we would love to do, and we have people who want to do it, right? Well, as parishes are hearing the vision and beginning to understand Bishop's vision and looking to how can we respond to it, they need support at different moments.
Right.
Sometimes they're like, actually, we're not sure. Like, how do we decide what to do? Well, the Discipleship and Evangelization Office can work with that parish to facilitate conversations, to help them kind of gather together the creativity and inspirations that God is raising up in their parishes. Sometimes they know what they want to do, but they're like, oh, I don't know if we have any people to do it.
Right. Or we need technology to do it.
Right.
Or whatever it is.
Whatever the sticking point is, right? And there's so many places, and I know this is my many years as a pastor in the diocese, that when you get to a sticking point, wow, what an amazing support we can receive from the diocese to do things that we could never do on our own as a parish.
Yeah.
And then furthermore, as a diocese, there's things that actually we just can't do at a parish level,
right,
but that can be done very effectively and very fruitfully at a regional or diocesan-wide level.
Yeah. So if you just joined us, we're talking to Mike Bannwarth and Father Scott Traynor about this year's Catholic Family Sharing Appeal and what to expect from that. So Father Scott, what do we know? This is a loaded question. Do we know any of the future things that we're going to be doing for Bishop's Vision? You're going to look at me like, no.
No, of course it is. No, it's a great question. It's a hard thing to narrow down.
Right.
Right. There's a few things. Like many people will be familiar with Totus Tuus.
Right.
That has been such an effective program run out of the youth office with Eric Gallagher for years and years in our diocese. Mm-hmm. And the fruit of that, in terms of forming missionary disciples, people who are encountering Christ, beginning and growing in relationship with him, and then going out and helping others to do the same through a deepening experience of God's love. Like that, there's a program that that happens so beautifully. This year, we've kind of, like last summer with COVID,
right,
for example, we couldn't do what Totus Tuus normally does,
mm-hmm,
but we had this great opportunity with a lot of I would say evangelical entrepreneurship, to be creative. Like, what can we do within the limitations that we're all going through in the middle of a pandemic?
Right.
And the impact that those missionary teams had in different parishes where they stayed for a month instead of just for a week, as usual, was profound. We keep hearing stories of lives that were impacted through that effort. So we're going to continue to expand that missionary program. It's going to be rebranded as Lumen Christi, mm-hmm, the Light of Christ.
Yep.
Both for the year, both during the summer and hopefully throughout the year in the coming years. That's one thing. We are going to start an initiative through the Discipleship and Evangelization Office called the Institute for Missionary Discipleship, IMD, right?
Oh, okay.
Missionary right. Discipleship Formation. And it's really like a brand name for just a variety of formation opportunities. So there's one thing to identify people who are inspired by this vision and have gifts that God has given them that they want to bring forward. But how do you equip them to be fruitful in the work that they want to do in their local area or regionally or even at the diocesan level?
Mm-hmm.
And there's a myriad of formations. So, for example, to grow in relationship with God, which is at the heart of missionary discipleship, mm-hmm, people have to learn how to pray, right?
Right.
I've done a lot of work over the years with the Institute for Priestly Formation, which exists to teach priests and future priests how to pray, how to grow in a personal relationship with God.
Mm-hmm.
In the coming year, we're going to be rolling out a number of resources. That's just something that any parish can use in a small group setting, as adult formation, for youth formation. Like, what does that look like? What are the tools I need? And they're simple things,
right,
but they're not together in one place.
Mm-hmm.
We want to pull those things together in one place, make them very accessible to people, to really help them at that very foundational level to meet and experience the love of God and to grow in relationship with him.
And it's much easier to do that at a diocesan mm-hmm level than at a parish level, to pull all those things together.
Right,
and
right. You know, parishes have so much going on. And again, I got to say that as a parish priest, right? There's always a ton of things going on and many things you can't kind of schedule for,
right?
Funerals and all the pastoral demands of a parish. It's great. That's the beauty of the parish family, right?
Mm-hmm.
So it's great to have at the diocesan level people whose job it is to gather together the best resources. We don't want to reinvent things. If great things are out there, we're just collecting them in a big warehouse, like
right,
getting an idea.
Right.
So when people are like, I'm looking for something that might do this, hey, here are five different options. What's going to be a great fit for you and your small group or your parish, right? That's what we can help parishes do. So again, it's really trying to amplify what's happening at the parish level with this kind of backstop support from the diocese.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. I like your acronym there too, IMD. It's like Impossible Missions Department. That was the first thing I thought of, making impossible missions possible, right?
That's great.
That can be your new tagline.
That's right. Another great initiative, Bishop DeGroote is such a great leader for our diocese, and he's really interested that all the work that the diocese is doing is really being aligned to advance this mission in the diocese. Mm-hmm. And one of the expressions of that is some new opportunities, like with Catholic Family Services, for example, who have done such great work offering counseling services and many other charitable outreaches over the years for people in need. Mm-hmm. And so one of the things we're really looking at, and I know this as a seminary formator also, thinking with our seminarians, really leaning on their human development, their human formation, Mm-hmm. So in seminary world, we talk about intellectual formation, spiritual formation, apostolate formation, like their mission work, and also their human formation. Mm-hmm. And today, one of the biggest challenges is that human formation element. Yeah. As people come from sometimes broken family situations or just, you know, the difficulties that young people in general face today, which are really different than 20 years ago or 30 years ago. And we're really excited to leverage the resources and the experience that Catholic Family Services has for our seminarians going through formation.
Yeah.
So that as a diocese, we're really maximizing the investment we make in seminarian formation so that they can be healthy, happy, and holy priests in the future.
Yeah, those are the best kind.
It is the best kind. That's exactly right. So I just love how Bishop's vision allows the alignment of those resources and the investments we make through CFSA to make that a reality.
Yeah. And, you know, just in the building, even everybody's really getting behind that mission and really excited about it. So I hope that will bleed over into the rest of the diocese and all of that can really take a lot of fruit on in the area. So Father, you of course ministered in a parish for a while in
a
Yankton, right?
Oh yes.
Yankton
and Beersford.
Okay.
And Brookings and a few places around the place.
Yeah. So what was your experience of CFSA while you're in a parish? Because clearly different than it is here.
Yeah. Yeah. I thought it was always such an important point each year to help people know that they're not only part of their parish, but that the Catholic Church, of which they're a member, is much bigger than just our parish.
Mm-hmm.
The parish is a family of families, but our diocese is a family of parishes.
Right.
And I think on my experiences, like going down to focus conferences where you have 15,000 college students from all over the country, or to World Youth Days with our Holy Fathers, right? The experience of just seeing that the church is so much bigger than the thing I'm familiar with every week and when I go into the church on Sunday, right? And it's an encouraging thing and a beautiful thing. So just to be able to tell each year the story of like, hey, what we're living each week in and week out here in our parish is part of a much bigger story and a beautiful story, something we can be so proud of, not only at the parish level, but as being part of our diocese and through our diocese as part of the universal church. So it was always a great opportunity just to tell that story and bring that encouragement. And then as Catholics made in God's image and likeness, we have a need to give.
Yeah.
We're made in God's image and likeness, and God so loved the world that he gave his only son. He gave us everything and made his image and likeness. Our fulfillment is wrapped up in having opportunities to give for things that are expressions of love to our brothers and sisters. And to see the amazing work, really with a relatively few number of, say, people and employees, the work that's done that is supported through CFSA is amazing. It has amazing fruitfulness. Again, amplifying the local work of parishes and doing so many other things that an individual parish never could do. And to be able to invite people to be part of that is a great privilege every year.
Yeah, I think it's important to just remember that we're here to help try to make life easier for the parishes and to just get the word of God out and help them do that. We aren't like our own parish or something over here. So,
In my years in Yankton, for example, we just on a regular basis, we were supported in our payroll and HR stuff, things we could never figure out as just a parish. We'd have to have a whole other full-time person, right?
Yep.
And the efficiencies of having the finance office be able to, and the HR office support us in those things. Never-ending calls to Don Wolf and the IT department for our internet
Don's
services
fabulous.
And how important that became that that was kind of bulletproof and rock solid when we got shut down for COVID so that we could actually stream the parish mass a week after we got shut down and how important that was to keep people connected. I was a Newman Center director. A third of my priesthood for 7 years in two of our different Newman Centers at SDSU and USD. Go Jacks.
Woo!
Go Yotes.
No.
Go. I'm very ecumenical. That's all right.
Mike and I.
Yeah.
So You know, like that whole ministry set at such a critical time, reaching out to college students.
Yeah.
What the decisions they make there are going to impact their practice of their faith or not for the next couple decades of their life,
right,
most likely. And to see the fruitfulness of those ministries, which are totally not possible without the generous support that we receive from CFSA.
Yeah, especially important right now in the world we live in.
When people look at that list, I always love this every year too. The CFSA office always did a great job of like, hey, here are the ministries that are supported. Mm-hmm. When people look at that, and if they can sit down with their pastor or someone who's knowledgeable and like, these are the actual things that happen and the lives that are impacted on this list of stuff.
Right.
I mean, it's endless.
Yep.
And it's an amazing thing. I think of like the multiplication of loaves and the fish. It's like, here's a few gifts that are brought forward and then the explosive fruit as God blesses that generosity in really impacting lives, people's lives with God's love.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's amazing.
That's good to hear that coming from a parish priest. So, Mike, before we wrap up, is there anything we missed? Anything we need to add?
You know, a couple things that came to mind as we were talking, mm-hmm. You think of the different purposes in ministries for Catholic Family Sharing Appeal and seminary and education, mm-hmm. year after year comes to mind, but then to hear you describing it now and the collaboration with the different areas and Catholic mm-hmm. Family Services and all the, so we're taking it to a whole different level. And mm-hmm. I think that's the beauty of a lot of what we're talking about, looking for the future. The other thing that really comes to mind is taking a step back and just really with CFSA, from Bishop and from the diocese, a sense of gratitude to all of the parishioners, not only monetarily, but as I mentioned, with their prayerful support, because we don't want to take that for granted.
Yeah, keep that up. We really need it.
Absolutely. And so just a very big thank you to all of those that support CFSA.
Yeah, I'm glad you said that. I forgot that part. Thanks. All right, I guess we better wrap it up. Otherwise, we'll have no room for Dr. Bergwald at the beginning. So thanks, you guys, for being here.
Thank you, Renee.
All right. Next week, we're actually going to have Father Traynor back to talk about Lent before we begin our Lenten season. So I hope you'll come back for that. That is it for us today. Hope you'll join us next week for more Catholic Views.